model from Kolkata brutally murdered, stabbed 22 times by an Ola cab driver in Bengaluru, smashing her head after he drove her to an isolated place. The Bombay High Court comes down hard on the state government during the Mahul hearing, refuses to grant it more time to arrive at a decision for the resident's future rehabilitation. The Supreme Court to continue hearing the Enforcement Directorate's plea on interim protection to P. Chidambaram today. The top court had given Chidambaram protection from arrest till today. This is yet another poll bonanza by the Delhi Chief Minister. After free electricity and Wi-Fi, he's now announced water bill arrears to be waived off under a special scheme. The Mumbai's ambitious project, the monorail, which has flopped after having spent 3,000 crore rupees to build this. The service has few takers and it continues to incur losses worth lakhs each single day. Prime Minister Modi has today visited late Arun Jaitley's residence to pay his last respects. Prime Minister was joined by Home Minister Amit Shah. India's Sumit Nagpal has given legendary Roger Federer a scare at the US Open before going down fighting in round one. He becomes the first Indian to take a set off the 20-time Grand Slam champion in a major event. After receiving an absolute champion's welcome at the Delhi airport, PV Sindhu meets with the Prime Minister and Sports Minister Kiran Rijiju for having won the gold in the World Badminton Championships. You are with The Big Story with us. Thanks for being with us. I'm Sahar Zaman. In the top focus, the gruesome case here regarding the Kolkata-based model Pooja Singh Day. She was murdered in Bengaluru by an Ola cab driver. This incident took place when the victim was on her way to the airport close to 4 a.m. on the 31st of July. The driver allegedly took her to an isolated spot, demanded all her valuables. When she refused, the driver hit her. Hit her over the head with a rod. He then allegedly stabbed her 22 times before smashing her head with a stone. 2 days after committing the crime, the accused then texted the model's husband using the victim's phone, demanding 5 lakh rupees, citing an emergency. Model's husband grew suspicious about this message and the broken English text, after which he flew down to Bengaluru and contacted the police. The victim allegedly hadn't booked the cab via the Ola cab app, because of which this trip was not on record with the aggregator. But today we are asking, it is very clear, it is evident that not enough stringent measures by governments are being done to keep a check on whether cab aggregator services are doing required background checks before hiring their drivers.
We are going to be working very closely with Ola and Uber. In fact, I'm not at all happy with the way they are recruiting drivers. They are just picking up all kind of riffraff and giving them a license to drive vehicles, like the unfortunate incident which took place. Irrespective of what a client does, meets or goes somewhere, their duty is to give service. In this case, we will be invoking the provisions of law against Ola, because if they are a service provider, they better be responsible for what kind of service they are giving. Okay. And definitely the fear which some women have at night, we will remove that fear, and I will intensify our checking of these vehicles, especially on the airport stretch where these instances have happened. And KSRTC and BMTC have monitors which check their buses. I'm going to insist on these two aggregators also to have monitors, check vehicles in the night as well as in the day. They will be liable for criminal action. Whosoever was responsible for selecting that driver has to face criminal action,
right.
And it will be happen. And if they don't, we will take it, we will escalate it up to the management, and we will see that if it requires cancellation of the license, that also we'll do. Women's safety is of paramount importance, and there's no compromise on that.
All right, Bengaluru Police Commissioner being very clear that there will be action taken against Ola. They're responsible for providing services, safe services to their passengers. We're going to throw this open to our panelists with us. We have Mr. S. Srinath, who's a spokesperson, the Karnataka BJP with us. We also have Ms. Brinda Adige, women's rights activist. Going to them across in just a bit. First, taking in quick inputs coming in from our correspondent, Neha, with more details here on this case. Neha, this is, of course, with respect to action that needs to be taken against the cab aggregator service, because this is not the first time that this an incident wherein which questions being asked where drivers' background checks aren't being done. The police has made it very clear that action would be taken against Ola. We're also looking at the government's role here on this in bringing about certain guidelines which makes Ola and Uber feel the heat of being responsible for passenger safety.
Absolutely, Sahar, that's right. It seems like somewhere you're given to understand that, you know, these private taxi aggregators, cab aggregators are not taking enough responsibility for their actions, owing to which they're being let off the hook. And it's most unfortunate, a case that's come to light now. But what is even more unfortunate is that this may not be the last such case, as much as we'd like for it to be, because that's what ideally, you know, the women of the city ideally feel. Let's bring in some voices over here from some women who ideally, you know, travel by these cabs on a daily basis. Let's find out how safe or unsafe they feel. Now, first of all, let's actually find out from you, how safe do you feel while traveling in a cab at night, before, you know, getting down to the mechanism of how you try to combat it? Would you feel safe taking a cab tonight on your own?
So basically, not everyone will feel safe by taking cab on their own at during a night, but then yeah, people will have their own necessities so that they have to do that.
Okay.
It is kind of unsafe, everyone will feel, in today's world.
All right.
Yeah.
Okay, now also coming to you, it seems like, you know, a little while earlier when we were speaking to you, you said there are a lot of things that you do in order to ensure your safety. Now, what are these things, and how, you know, how would you go ahead and what advice would you give to the other women as well?
Okay, so basically I share my ride with my mom or my dad and any other people, and then take a screenshot of those with whom I'm riding, which are whatever cab details, and pass it on to others so that they have a track on where am I and did I reach my location or not. I keep calling and telling them that I'm here and I reached or I got my cab or anything like that.
Okay, all right. Now also coming to you, you also seem like someone that takes, you know, cabs pretty frequently at night. How safe or unsafe is it that you feel?
No, it's not about being safe or unsafe. Yeah, obviously all of us would want to feel safe, but then not every driver is bad. And in this generation, you have a lot of security, safety measures that any cab transport takes. When we travel, we have something called sharing contacts, so that helps us. And when it comes to women, there are pink cabs right now where women drivers take care. So that's a really good thing happening.
Okay, all right. There you have it, really, Sahar. Of course, a mixed bag of voices over here. While some of the women in Bengaluru feel extremely unsafe, they've figured out ways to combat it. But other section of women in the city, and more importantly also in the state, still feel unsafe and hope and pray that, you know, every cab ride of theirs does not turn out to be a nightmare at night.
That's right. It is a question of taking a chance that you're traveling, you're on board a vehicle with a driver who's safe with you, be it any odd time of the night or daylight. Neha, appreciate you getting us those responses here from women passengers. Stay on with us. Let's get in a response here from the BJP. Mr. Anand Gurumurthy, spokesperson of Karnataka BJP with us. Mr. Anand, in your view, how can the government, your state government, step in on this? Last year, which was the previous government in Karnataka, said that they're going to be launching their own app-based taxi service precisely for this reason, that Ola and Uber rides are becoming unsafe for women. Are you going to be taking ahead that plan with the new government now today?
Actually, that was an election manifesto thing of the JDS, which was the Kumaraswamy government. We had not any, you know, BJP as such has not spoken about it. But regarding this women safety issue, the commissioner has clearly talked about it.
It was a word that came in from the transport minister when the government was in power last year. Are you going to be carrying
that
forward that?
Mr. Kumar's from his government.
No such thing has been discussed regarding BJP government going to be carrying forward a positive measure in this direction? Okay.
The measures will be law and order measures related to the law and order. As the commissioner spoke of, more safety devices related things will be taken up with the cab aggregators. So anything that can be done with technology will be done, and also certain safety measures for the citizens. The citizens who are using these services must be educated on certain things, going through the process and not missing out on any step of the process. Because ultimately, if the process is followed, we are observing that everything is going fine. But again, we cannot blame the victims. Certain things which the commissioner told
whose responsibility is
much
Mr.
on the dot, on
Guru
the
point. Murthy, but whose responsibility is it to ensure that the process is being followed? Safety measures, processes are being followed for drivers, background check. Can we have the government with the state police department and the state home ministry
ensuring that you have
cab aggregator services following the rules on this? Because they're not.
Yes, it is the home departments, and the commissioner has, taken the responsibility for it, and he has ensured that in future it will be taken care in a more strict way. He has already talked
about
it.
Well, Anand, stay on with us. Let's also get in a word here. He has already talked about it, but we need to hear from the government of the day here as well. And we haven't here on this front because we're also still waiting for ministers to be given portfolios to start some work on ground. Ms. Brinda Adige, women's rights activist here with us as well. Brinda, thanks for being with us. We are looking at measures and means wherein which that can work. Let me take that question to Brinda first, please. On how the government can step in and sending out very stern warnings and message signal to the cab aggregator services here that there is going to be zero tolerance if you have Ola or Uber in these cases here who are not doing the required background checks. There is going to be zero tolerance as far as the given state government of the place there is concerned.
You're absolutely right. Due diligence, background check, but that's just the initial step. What is more important is how much do these systems function when the need actually arises? Because this particular person did whatever he did, probably with that impunity that he is not going to get caught. Even if he gets caught, the punishment is going to take years together because of our criminal justice system. So we cannot say that just the police have to look into it and see what has to be done. What is our entire criminal justice system doing? What are our courts doing? Why do they delay cases of this nature? How quick are the helplines of Ola itself or Uber itself? Because we know that many times when a complaint is made, it takes time. They do not respond to it immediately, even though they have the technology in place, because that's what they say, they have the technology in place and they would be immediately able to look through the satellite if some other detour has been taken. So why have they not done all these things? Is it because that Ola as a company is not being charged, is not being held responsible by the government? And that, I think, is a very, very serious concern. What stake does the company have in cases like this?
Mm-hmm. All right. Mr. Anand, would you like to respond to that? Because now we have ministers with their respective portfolios there. In the past few days, of course, we were looking at a lot of citizens speaking out, saying that we're expecting the government to start work, governance, which is missing on ground. Today, can we expect a more stringent measure, a warning sign coming in from the government in the wake of this heinous crime, that this is a pressing urgency, this is a heinous crime that has taken place, and the government of the day is going to hold Ola and Uber and other cab aggregator services responsible directly if passengers' safety is not their priority, if they're not doing the driver background check?
See, the investigation officer comes from the police department. This has nothing to do with the old government or new government or any government. The investigating officer comes from the police department, and the commissioner himself has told that he will be holding responsible for the person who has recruited the driver. So it clearly means that he is going to hold the company responsible. So let the investigation is going on, and let them, you know, present it before the court and take it forward. Okay, so irrespective of the governments, okay, nobody, you know, is for any change that will bring in more safety or anything. It is something which has to be understood very clearly that the government is for women's safety, and that's our point. And, you know, elaborating on these things, saying that the government has come into picture now. No, IPC sections have been there it's been there from past 70, 75 years, and it's been going on. So we cannot, you know, term this as something as a government failure or anything like that. Measures are there. It has been taken. And now, since the government representative in this case is the police commissioner himself, and he is the one who appoints the investigating officer, he is terming that he is going to make sure that those who are responsible for recruiting the driver will also be held. I think this will go in the right direction.
Okay.
And it will...
Brinda, I see you nodding in disagreement in there, because there was a similar case of violence by a cab driver that took place last year. This was with the previous government in Karnataka, in which Karnataka said, we're going to be starting our own cab services here because Ola Uber are doing no good for passenger safety. There was a case in 2014 which happened in Delhi, wherein the Delhi government stepped in and said, Uber needs to be banned. We're going to be looking at ways on working around how passenger safety can be ensured. Don't you think that the government today should speak out here on this? Is it not important for the government to speak out here on this?
The police commissioner, all of them step in when the crime has been committed. Yes, there are laws over there and the investigation will happen. But let us be very clear. How do we hold the company responsible? Somebody hired. Why did they not do due diligence? What is the other measures that have been put into place when somebody sees that a particular car has taken a detour? Now, that cannot be the police commissioner's responsibility or the police's responsibility. And let me also put in a small note over here. The Karnataka police is spread so thinly. They have such few people doing all of these various works that telling them that now he's responsible and he will do it and he will catch the company. You know that the law for the Ola and Uber is so different. The small print is that the company is never held responsible. That is why we are asking the entire government setup to come in and hold the Ola and Uber accountable for whatever their employees do. It cannot be that I've done a contract system and I have now become so evasive that you will not, by law, technically hold me responsible. So we need to take into consideration, now crime has happened, of course the police will come into place, of course the investigation happens, and the IPC since 1846 will be in place. What do we do? Do we wait for every crime to happen? Shall we not prevent it? Should we not send out a message of fear of the law? Should that not be a deterrent? So why is my government not taking responsibility?
Mr. Anand, please respond here to this. We're looking at preventive measures here that need to be brought in by the government as well.
Preventive measures are in place. In this case, what you're speaking of, I'm not a spokesperson of any company here. I'm spokesperson of representing the BJP here. And let me tell you, Brinda, the way you're telling, the number of bookings that are happening through all these cab aggregators, they're across the world, these cab aggregators are being used. Okay, and if due diligence is maintained, we are all using it on a daily basis. So this is an one-off incident and it has to be taken seriously. Even one-off incident cannot be let off, and it's against the law, and something against the law has happened and it is being investigated.
But
and
where
the
commissioner is it? Has Mr. come Anand, out saying that,
yes,
a one-off
we'll
incident?
Hold the companies responsible.
Mr. Anand, the very reason that we are having this discussion, because there is a scaring increase in frequency with which these crimes are taking place involving cab drivers of these cab aggregator services, knowing that background checks have not been done, knowing that these companies think that they'll get away with it. They release one copy-pasted statement in each of these cases to the extent that we know these
that's
statements
why,
by
that's
heart.
Why the commissioner's
There's
statement
so
is
many
very
cases
important
of these.
Here.
There are copy-pasted statements here saying that we are horrified this is taking place. We have zero tolerance towards this. We have sacked the concerned driver.
You are not letting me complete my statement. Please let me complete my statement. No, 1 minute. Let me complete my statement. That's where
you completed your statement already. They're saying, Mr. Anand, that this is a one-off case. This is not a one-off case.
Madam, you didn't let me complete my statement. You interrupted me. In this case also, the law, this is...
Complete, please.
What I'm trying to tell you is, millions and millions of bookings are happening in this country. 1 minute, let me complete my statement. Millions and millions of bookings are happening in this country, and one booking has gone, this thing which was not booked through the aggregator system. That's what the reports have been. It was not booked through the aggregator system. It was something like directly it was the driver was called in and something like that happened. But even then, the commissioner has come up with a statement saying that something wrong and we are going to, hold everybody in the chain responsible. That's the commissioner's statement, and that's what we have to consider here. We cannot, go on saying that the due diligence was not done.
Yes, that is the commissioner's statement in investigating a crime that has already taken place. Do not take the commissioner's statement to your credit here. The police is doing its job after a crime has already taken place. Do not take the commissioner's statement
to your
credit.
No, we are not taking anything to credit. I am just mentioning that they are doing their duty.
Is for the government to step in and announce preventive measures, strong deterrents for companies such as Ola and Uber that these crimes do not happen. Let me get in a citizen's voice.
1 minute,
Mr. Anand, you will understand the plight. You hear a citizen's voice. Miss Olivia,
a
citizen's voice with us over the phone line. Olivia, please go ahead. Anand, you will have to listen to a citizen's voice here. Olivia, please go ahead.
And I was brave enough to call out for cops, and I did not speak to people in the cab.
Is my voice going through, please?
Can you hear me? Am I audible?
Yes, please go ahead.
Yeah, so what I said was, luckily I was awake in the cab and I had booked it through Ola, and I still remember the driver who was driving the vehicle was not the person's face in the app. Was a different, the brother of the actual driver who was registered in the system. And the second of all, first of all, this, something like this should not be allowed. But then still the driver was driving. He did not speak a word. And when I got into the cab and near Hebbal flyover, he was about to fall off from the flyover. Because he, later when I told that, please slow down, you don't have to rush, I'm not in a hurry. That's when he said, pocha dunga. And that's when I understood he's drunk because his eyes was red. And I did not even notice that he had started masturbating in the cab, which I wasn't even aware of. And that's when I, near the toll, I shouted saying, call the cops. And luckily the toll guys ran and stopped the vehicle, got me out from the cab. I was panicking at that moment. And from Hebbal flyover, the toll is at least 10 to 15 kilometers. And that was
that's
horrific,
right.
What I had
yes,
seen.
Olivia, we've read about your case earlier as well. Did you register a complaint against this, either with the police or the concerned cab aggregator?
Exactly. And he refused to. And after, when the cops were interrogating the driver, that why are you drunk and you're driving, he was telling me he lives near my house.
Right. Olivia, in your view, do you think that it is entirely the job or the responsibility of cab aggregator brands such as Ola and Uber for background check verifications of drivers that they're hiring? Or is it for the state government as well to be issuing notifications and guidelines that work as a deterrent? Because this isn't the first time that an incident with you that has happened or... even other horrifying cases wherein a passenger's life has been lost as well, murdered, raped, assaulted. For the government here to be sending out a sterner message that cab aggregator services cannot mess with the safety of passengers so frequently, so easily?